All right, so in the last lecture we discussed about a Flask directory structure, where we discussed these concepts that we have got this root folder, and in that root folder we have got a template folder and a static folder. So in this lecture or in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to code whatever I discussed in the last class about Flask directory structure. Now if you remember from the last from the second lecture of the of this series, that we coded this function called getSentiment, which is going to take a text and it is going to return a textual representation of that text in form of its sentiment. So if it is negative, it is going to give us a negative review in terms of whether it is highly negative or negative, right? So but we don't want to show this function to our user, whoever is going to be using our application. What we want to do is we want to make a web application where the user can come and type in his or her review and get the sentiment of that particular text. Or maybe we have an application where we want to where we are taking the reviews of customers, and we are interested in knowing how our customer are reviewing to our products. So these type of applications can be made using these concepts. So what I want to do in this lecture is to code the directory structure of the Flask. So currently we have only this file called main.py. Now what I want to do is I want to quickly make two folders in this particular folder. The first folder will be templates and second folder will be static. Now this folder should not be in the templates, it should be in the root folder. Now if you notice here, ignore this video 2 folder for a minute. You just need to focus on this video 3 folder. Now this video 3 folder is what is known as a root folder, and in this root folder we have got this main.py file, we have got this folder called static file, which can be used to hold all the static content like images, JavaScript and CSS. And in the templates folder we will be holding all the HTML files. Now in the main.py we are going to be coding the server part of our application. Now in the server part, what we are basically interested in is we want some way of serving the contents which is in the templates folder. So for example, I have got an HTML page which I want to serve through a web page. What I can do is I can take help of Flask, right? So how can we achieve this task? So what we are going to do here is we are going to import from Flask, import Flask. So all the Flask apps need to import this Flask class. Now what we want to do is we want to create this app in this Flask, and we are going to pass the name of this script. This name is a special reserved constant in Python which is used for the script name main.py for the current Python file. Now we have defined this application. Now how are we going to run this application? We are going to run this application if main is equal to name, and we are going to run this application as app.run. So run is a method of this app class, this Flask class. Now we are going to run this application by calling this method, and we are going to be also passing one important parameter called debug is equal to true. Now what this debug is equal to true does is it exposes few methods that are helpful while debugging our web application. Okay, once this is ready, we can actually run the application. But if we can run the application, but what the problem is that this server is not currently pointing to any route. Now we will be explaining what the route is in the next lecture. Currently you just need to understand that there is this notion of route, and in each route we have to render some web pages, right? So to render some web pages, for the time being, what we want to do is we want to just render a text statement in the web application. Okay, so we will create a route by calling this app.route decorator. Now this decorator is decorator in Python is used before any function name. So we call this app.route, and we are passing this app.route a string representation of backward slash. This is pointing to the route name. So the route is backward slash, or in another words, it is also known as home route. Okay, now I'm going to define a function. Define index. So this route is known as index route, and this route is pointing to this function index. Now with this index function, I can return some text, any HTML expression. If you have if you are familiar with HTML expression, in HTML we have got this h1 tag which refers to the header tag. In this header tag I can write something of Flask application. So in this way, what I am doing is I'm rendering this HTML page using this main.py server. Okay, I'm serving this HTML page. Okay, in the next lecture we are also going to be discussing about how we will be serving pages from this templates folder, and how can we include static content. But for now this will do, and we are also going to be copying this function that we will be using after some time. Currently we want to make sure that our app is working, and we don't need these two print statements now. So our server is ready to run this server. What we need to do is, from the root folder we can run this main.py file. Okay, first of all, video.3. cd video. So now we can run from the root folder, we can run this main.py file. So if we don't get any error, that means our server worked, and it is going to be pointing us to a URL. This is our URL that we can copy and paste in our browser to visit the web page that our server is creating. Okay. As you can see, this is our Flask application, and it is bold, which indicates that this is the h1 tag that is rendered by our Flask server. And if we are inspecting this, and we can see that it is correctly rendering the tag that we expected it to render. Alright, I hope all the things that I have said in this video made sense to you. In the next lecture we will be discussing how we can render templates, render HTML pages from this template folder, and further I will be discussing how we can style our HTML page using CSS, which we will be putting in as static content. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please give it a like and share it if you find it helpful. Thank you. Have a nice day.